So welcome back guys to another video, and today I'm doing a review on the Caligula Effect Overdose, out now for the Nintendo Switch. I have to give a big shout and a huge thank you to the folks at NIS of America for sending a review copy to the studio. I'm going to try to make this review very spoiler free. But without further ado, let's get into it. Starting first with the story, the vocal software known as Mew has enabled people to escape from the despairs of reality by listening to her music, and those who are saved are granted every wish and live through Mobius. Mobius is a virtual atmosphere that takes place in high school, just blissfully unaware that this is not reality. Your character, though, finds a small group of men and women and figure out that Mobius is not the real world and form the Go Home Club. In order to find a way back to reality, each one of them has also violated certain taboos, and each one has a dark secret. But there are also 8 composers who provide the music for Mew called the Osnatu Musicians, and they oppose the Go Home Club and try to stop the group from unraveling the rabbit hole. With gameplay and controls, this is a JRPG through and through. Each member of the Go Home Club fights with a catharsis effect, a black mass that erupts out of them and forms into weapons and accessories that represent each member's true self. It also can cause parts of their personality that were normally repressed to come to surface. The battle system has its own twists, and instead of your usual take turns, you can actually select chains and watch the battle unfold. You can also make kind of like a mock-up simulation that can really help decide the best path for victory. It's not 100% accurate, but it's pretty cool. There are 9 main characters that can be used in your party as the story progresses, but also there are NPCs that you can recruit into your party after they obtain at least level 2 or higher. And with that being said, this game has tons of content. Let's start with the things I really enjoy about this game. I enjoyed the battle system. I liked the fact that it was fast paced, but at the same time it had some strategy to it that just kept the juices flowing. I liked the fact that I could just build a whole battle system and kind of simulate and kind of spectate if it's going to go exactly the way I wanted to. I really enjoyed that. I enjoy building the relationships with the NPCs, the Go Home Club, the musicians. Without spoiling too much, there are multiple endings to this game, so I could see someone playing this game not once but 3 times to find the answer they're looking for. And for a JRPG, I definitely commend that, because many JRPGs I know that I've played in the past, I would play it, beat it once, and the only time I would really go back is to maybe go down the nostalgia train. So with that, this game's really got a lot going for it. And if you're a huge fan of the Persona series or Tokyo Mirage from the Wii U, this game may seem very similar, and rightfully so, because it has the same writer from the Persona 2 series. So essentially, this is almost the closest that we'll get to having Persona on the Nintendo Switch other than Joker being on Smash. Now with that being said, the things that I love about this game, I can see many folks not liking about this game because it is, in many ways, overwhelming. I will admit, if this wasn't on the Nintendo Switch, if this wasn't a game that I could take on the go and play on slow work hours, I don't know if I would still be committed to play this game as much, because it is very overwhelming. And that's one of the reasons why I love this game being on the Nintendo Switch. That and the Unreal 4 engine actually makes this game a lot of ways the definitive version, because it does have improved frame rate. So with that being said, I've had to give this game a score. I'm going to have to give it an 8 out of 10. I do recommend this game for JRPG fans. You're definitely going to be in a treat for checking this game out. But this is where I want you guys to come in. Leave a comment below. I'd love to hear some of your thoughts. Is this a game that you want to check out? Is this one that you're going to pass? I love to discuss it with you guys. Anyway, as always, thanks for watching, thanks for subscribing, and as always, happy gaming.